again, and welcome back to my little studio. In my first video, I introduced myself and told you a bit about who I am and some of the things that I like. Now, I want to spend some time with you, as I promised, telling you what a bishop is and what is it that bishops do and why do we wear the things we wear. I hope that you find my videos helpful, and I promise they will never be too long, and I hope will never be boring. God bless you, and take a look at this. The story of the bishop began when Jesus rose from the dead on the first Easter day. The first person to discover that Jesus was alive again was Mary. Mary told her story as to how Jesus spoke to her, and she quickly began to share it with her friends. At first they did not believe her, but soon others came to his tomb and they too believed, and they ran to tell other people. As you might imagine, people had a hard time believing those brand new stories of Jesus, who everyone knew was dead, somehow was alive again. Jesus appeared to his disciples. He spent time with them, and then he told them they had something to do. Soon, many other people saw Jesus too, and they began to believe and celebrate. Jesus told them everyone was going to be invited to share in his work of sharing God's love with the whole world, everywhere and for all time. That means you and me. Jesus said, go into the world, tell people that God loves them, teach people about that love, and then when they believe, baptize them so they can show the world that they are followers of Jesus too. Jesus called it making disciples. We know it as the Great Commission. When the church was very young, people gathered as often as they could to worship, to pray, to sing, to share Holy Communion, and learn how they should live and grow as disciples. You see, disciples understood that they were students who followed Jesus, who needed a teacher. Isn't that like confirmation class? The very first followers of Jesus were people who actually saw him, spoke to him, ate with him, and were sent by him. They became the leaders of what we call the early church. And before too long, those first leaders were known as bishops. And because the church was growing so fast, people needed more and more people who would lead, teach, and help everywhere. And so, bishops would gather people together, and those who felt somehow that God was speaking to them to serve in a special way were prayed over. The bishop would put hands on their heads and ordain them. And then they were sent out to serve. Your minister was ordained in exactly the same way by a bishop. And in some ways, you were ordained too. Your baptism, and now your confirmation. And we'll be talking about that with you throughout this whole confirmation preparation. So now you see, bishops were set aside to do special things. They were, first of all, leaders. They were also teachers. They were people who ordained others and sent them into the world, and they were people who had the special job of making sure that there was love and agreement in the church, and that the same things about Jesus were being taught everywhere. The word for that is unity. And you know, bishops have been doing that type of ministry for over 2,000 years. Let's move on now and answer a question that I hear fairly often. Why do bishops wear all that stuff? That's a good question. A simple answer is that bishops wear different things so that people will know that the bishop is here among the people. It goes back to early times. You see, when the church was new, bishops actually became recognized by the Romans as being important in society, and they gave them the authority to be like judges or police. They were allowed to rule over Christian people in matters of things like law, schools, money, charity, and the things that could actually be said about Jesus. And they were allowed to dress like Roman rulers of the time. They wore special hats that had this shape, almost like a triangle. They carried a staff or a stick to show that they had power and authority. And they wore special rings as signs that they were representatives of a higher power. The ring became a sign of their duty. And so you see, when you wore these things, you also had a responsibility to the people and to the church and to the government. Often when the bishop would arrive in a place, people would celebrate with singing and parades and great feasts. All this was done to show love for Jesus and his church. To be thankful for the arrival of the bishop was to be thankful that Jesus had sent people to teach, to share, and that Jesus was with us always. So today, when you see a bishop, you may see him or her wearing everyday clothing, like I usually am when I'm out in my yard or here in my studio. You may see a bishop wearing a purple shirt with a cross around their neck. The purple shirt reminds us of the royalty of Jesus. The cross a bishop wears is usually fairly large and reminds us that Christians have a job to do. It is a bit heavy, so when we see the cross, it reminds us that we should share heavy loads and we should pray for one another. When in church, you see that the bishop is usually pretty dressed up. You notice the hat? It's called a mitre, and it is shaped to remind us of a flame, the flame of the Holy Spirit and the fire of God's love. Here on the back of the mitre, you see two strips. We call them lappets, and they are there to remind us of the Bible. First of all, the Gospels, which are the stories of people who were actually with Jesus, and the epistles, which are letters that we can read in the Bible, which were sent to new churches everywhere. They are to give us teaching and to share the story of the early church. And the bishop wears a flowing robe known as a cope, which matches the colors of the mitre. It reminds us of the importance of Jesus in the world and in the church. When we dress up to honor him. The bishop will still carry a staff, which we call a crozier. It's a sign of his or her duty as being the main teacher and caretaker of a group of churches. We call that group a diocese. When a bishop visits another diocese, they may wear the cope and the mitre, but they do not carry the crozier. You only carry the crozier in your own diocese. The bishop wears a special ring. Rings can be large or small, and usually have a purple stone. The ring sometimes is used like a fingerprint to sign documents. It's always meant to show the special place of the bishop as a teacher and someone who looks over the diocese to make sure everyone is doing okay. Now, there are a few other things that only bishops wear and do, but what I've just shared gives you some idea. And please remember, please, please, please remember that whatever a bishop wears or does, your bishop is a brother or sister to you because of Jesus. Never meant to stand away from you or over you or above you, but someone who is always trying to bring us into a deeper and more beautiful relationship with Jesus and with each other. God bless.